welcome to my first video of 2019. I definitely meant to have a couple of other things edited over my winter break, and I wanted to have a couple of good things up, but last night I was watching YouTube videos, as you do, and I was inspired by another YouTuber. Her YouTube channel is called Bobbins and Bows, but her actual name is Fiona. She is awesome. I love her a lot. Fiona, if you're watching this, hello. When are we gonna collab? I'm coming for you, girl, this year, I swear. But she posted a 2019 cosplay resolutions video, and I did one of these kind of videos a couple years ago. I think it was like back in 2016. I just thought it might be a good way to kind of get new energy rolling on my channel, because as you guys know, 2018 was not a great year for me on YouTube. Personally, it was a fine year, but I really didn't do much on this platform in particular. Before we jump in, I dyed my hair green a couple days ago, and every single camera that I have, it looks awful on. Like, it on my viewfinder right now, it looks like brown green, like swamp colored. But it's actually, like, really cool. It sucks that, like, I can't actually show you guys what this color looks like because it looks terrible in every photo and video I take of it. But I'm really into it. It's more of like a almost like Beast Boy colored green. It's really cool. So I'm gonna be talking about my cosplay resolutions, and then I'm also gonna be talking about my convention plans for the year, as well as my actual cosplay plans. So my first resolution is to compete more. I really enjoy cosplay competition, and it's something that I have become more fond of over the years because it's something that really makes me push my skills, and it's definitely made me tend to make cleaner costumes than I used to. So in theory, I would like to compete twice this year. That would be pretty cool. I'm not really sure if that's gonna happen for sure. We'll get into what conventions I'm planning on competing at later and with what, but hopefully twice. That would be really cool, and obviously I'd like to place both times. I'm currently in the intermediate division. I have 4 awards, which is not anything crazy. I've only competed 5 times in my entire life, so I'm not an expert or anything, obviously, which is why I'm not in Master. But eventually I have some friends who are Masters that would really like to compete with me in the upcoming year or two, and I would really like to get some more competitions under my belt before I dive into competing with Masters, because when you compete, you have to go into the level of like the highest person, so I would have to compete in Master if I competed with my Master friends, which is really scary. In that same vein, my second resolution is to work on my finishing techniques. I wouldn't say that I'm somebody that has sloppy costumes by any means. Like I said, over the past couple years I've really focused on improving the quality of my costumes and everything, but I think this year I really want to try to use more seam finishes as opposed to just serging my seams, or I would really like to try lining most of my stuff. I'd usually line a lot of my things anyway, but just to kind of make it more consistent, and then going into more things like detailing. I've never done satin stitch applique before, and I'm about to do that on the cosplay that I'm working on right now. So I think this is a year that I want to focus on like the little details, I guess, in my cosplays, because I understand patterning, I understand how to sew, like I can make a costume, but I think it's time for me to try to bump up my costumes to the next level with more attention to detail. My third resolution is to work on a complex wig, which is actually something that I've been doing for a while now. If you guys have been following me on Instagram, which is also at FairyKisu, I have been working on a wig for my Amaterasu cosplay, which I'll talk about later. The design isn't super crazy, but the amount of work that I'm having to put into this wig is a lot more than I originally anticipated, and it's having me learn a lot of new techniques. A lot of new techniques, yes. After this video, I'm actually planning on hopefully finishing that wig today, which includes dyeing it. I'm really nervous about that, but yeah, it has to be done, so. I've been really wanting to improve my wig game for a while now. I'm not bad at wigs, but I'm not nearly as comfortable with them as I am with sewing, and I think that's an area where I could use some improvement. When I look at my cosplays for the year, I don't really have anything super crazy aside from my Amaterasu wig that I am going to be working on, but hopefully I can work something in that will make me feel like I did something cool with a wig. And my fourth and final resolution is to work on a prop build. If you guys have been following me for a while, you might notice that I really don't do props. I think like the most prop-related thing I've made in the past couple years is my wings and tail for my mint costume from Tokyo Mew Mew. And those were like pieces of foam glued together. Prop making and armor and things like that does not come very easily to me. For sewing, it's really easy for me to like look at a costume or look at a character and figure out like, okay, this is exactly what I have to do, and then execute that and it comes out great. But with props, like, I don't know what to make things out of. I don't know how to build, disassemble if it's something really big that has to be collapsed down. Like, I don't know how to make things move. I don't understand anything. So props have always been a challenge for me, and I've kind of avoided them because of that. So I think this year I'd really like to challenge myself and make something more than a pair of foam wings. So those are all my resolutions for the year, cosplay-wise. It's more of goals for me to hit as opposed to resolution. So for my convention plans for the year, I'm kind of changing things up a little bit this year as opposed to what I would normally do, I guess. Because I'm getting a little bit older and I was gonna say I have more money, but I really don't because of like bills and everything. But I have like a consistent job where I'm able to save up money over time. I'm trying to kind of hit up bigger cons and different ones than I've been going to. So my first con of the year is not going to be Anime Milwaukee. I know I usually go to AMKEY, but I am not going this year because I'm actually planning on going to ASEM this year. So my first con of the year is going to be No Brand Con in March, which is at the Chula Vista in the Wisconsin Dells. As you guys might know, I actually staff that convention. I run the cosplay contest there, and I'm also in charge of merchandise this year. So although that's my first con of the year, I'm not really going to be cosplaying at that con. I'm not going to be vlogging. I am just going to be there, and I'm going to run the cosplay competition, and I hope it goes better than last year. Not to make this into an advertisement or anything, but if you guys are interested in coming to No Brand, our registration prices are really inexpensive. We are a pretty small con, and unfortunately, No Brand is kind of dying out because a lot of people are interested in bigger cons at this point. But if you guys like smaller cons and you don't have a ton of money, and if you're in the Wisconsin area, it is a water park con. It's at the Chula Vista, and I think our reg price is like, I don't even know, but it's definitely under like $30 or $40. It's really inexpensive. So that's what I'll be doing in March. We usually have our con in April, but dates got kind of weird because of scheduling and all that. Then after that, in May, like I mentioned, I'm going to be going to ASEN. This is my first year going to ASEN. I'm really excited. It's actually going to be right before finals for me, which kind of sucks, especially because the group I'm going with is leaving on Thursday, so I'm going to have to miss some class to go. But I'm really excited to do that. I'm not really sure exactly what I'm bringing for cosplays yet. But we'll kind of get into that in a minute. And then in July, me and the Daikon girls are going to be going to ICON, which is in Winnipeg in Canada. I'm really excited about this because I've also never been to ICON. I've never actually left the country, but I'm really excited about that, especially because it's going to be a weekend for the Daikon girls. My roommate, Rioso, is actually not going to be there because she's going to a Disney convention. So she can't afford to do both, but the rest of us are all going to be in Winnipeg in July. As far as I know, they haven't released official dates yet for ICON this year, but last year it was in July, so it's probably going to be in July. This next one isn't really solid, and I'm kind of thinking that I'm not going to be able to make it, but I thought I would throw it out there anyway. A couple of my friends from Madison had mentioned going to Anime Magic in August, which is, I think it's a newer con. I've never heard of it before. I believe it's in the Rosemont area, kind of in northern Illinois. We talked about going. I'm not really sure if I can go just because, like, it's going to be right after ICON, which is going to be a really expensive convention for me. And it's also a really far drive since I now live in northern Wisconsin all year. So I'm not really sure about that one. I probably won't be able to make it, but it's something that I'm actually really interested in, so I might be able to go next year. And then finally in November, I'm planning on going to DaishoCon, which I go to every year. This is going to be my 6th or 7th DaishoCon this year, which is like really, really crazy. Okay, and finally I'm going to talk about my cos plans for the year. I have a few. So right now I'm currently working on my Amaterasu cosplay from Okami. If you guys have been following me for like 5 frickin' years, I did a version of Amaterasu back in 2014. I'm not going to show a picture of it because I think it's cursed. If you really want to find it, you can do some digging on the Daikon cosplay page and you can find photos of it, but I hate that costume. When I made it in 2014, I didn't really have enough knowledge to do the character justice. So I think it was about a year or two ago, my friend Mallory of Lovely Pixel Crafts, she does my on-screen art. She actually designed me a new Amaterasu cosplay. I've been working on it for a while now because it's kind of a really big dream project for me. So that's the wig I was talking about earlier that I'm gonna go try to finish after I film this. I bought the fabric back in August, and I didn't actually start cutting it until I think like Christmas this past year, so it's taken me a while to get into it just because the whole thing is made out of silk, and I don't want to mess it up, and it's really nerve-wracking for me because I just love this character so much and I love the design so much that I really want to make sure that I take my time. I've also considered competing with this costume. It's obviously nowhere near done right now, but I think the goal is I would really like to take it to ASEN if it's finished in time, and then I think I might try to compete at Daishokan with it. You guys might say like, oh Fairy, why don't you compete at ASEN? I am not good enough to compete at ASEN. You guys might be like, oh, but like, your costumes are so good, we think they look so good. No. ASEN competition is on another level just because the con is so big, and I don't really believe in my skills enough to compete at that convention. So that's gonna be a no for ASEN, but I think Daisho might work out for Ami. After that, for Icon, my friend Lexi and I are planning on making an Umbreon and Espeon duo to compete with at that con. This is the design that I'm gonna do. I don't have the Espeon saved on my phone, but this is what I'm gonna be making. Like I said, it's gonna be for Icon, and we are planning on competing, which I'm really excited about. I haven't started on this one yet, but I am really, really excited about it. I have also started to consider tackling another dream costume of mine, which is Princess Krehi from Princess Tutu. I'm hesitant about this one just because I don't want to sound like I don't think cosplayers that are curvy are good, because I love curvy cosplayers. My roommates are both two thick girls. I love them so much. But personally, there's a lot of weight that I would like to lose before I make that costume. I know you guys are probably like, Fairy, you look fine. I gained a lot of weight since going to college, like a lot of people do. My whole life I've been really, really skinny, and then when I got to college I gained like 50 pounds. So I'd like to get back down to around where I was in like mid-high school before I start that costume. And aside from that, I also really want to make sure that when I make the tutu, that it's really true to what an actual classical ballet tutu would be. There's a lot of trade secrets that are involved in tutu making, and it's actually really difficult to find good, proper information on tutus. So that's the reason why I haven't, like, even really considered this cosplay for now. It's been on my cosplanner since 2014. It's been 5 years that I've been wanting to make this costume. So Krehi is something that I'm thinking about doing this fall. Again, we'll see if that happens, because there's a few things that need to fall into place before I start working on that. There's a couple other like smaller things that I've been thinking about. There's a Princess Cadence design from My Little Pony that I've been thinking about doing. Just because Princess Cadence was my first competition piece back in 2014, and it's god awful, but I kind of just want to do a new Cadence to like show a glow up or something. I don't know. It's just fun for me to redo old characters. That's all that I have like solidly planned, aside from, sorry, my fish is coughing. Okay, he's fine. That was really weird. There's a few other things that I have that aren't really solidly planned, and some other things that are really small, like Lexi and I are planning on doing like Gastrodon hoodies for Daishokan, which are like these really small, tiny outfits. And we've also talked about doing Eeveelutions in Daikon, but I don't think that'll happen until next year. But yeah, keep an eye on my Instagram. I tend to be more active there, especially posting whips and everything. So that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. My camera's about to die suddenly, so I'm gonna make this quick. I will see you guys next time. Bye!